If they passed a law that made poetry a crime, I'd break that law every time and I would try to get life. I said if they passed a law that made poetry a crime, I'd break that law every time and I would try to get life. You see, the city of Decatur issued a warrant for me saying I harassed the police with broken English over breakbeats, but, Your Honor, you gotta see, I was minding my own business. He started messing with me. You see, my poetry is like origami. It's art with paper, but when I speak too real, they want to see my mouth taped up. They want to see my art raped up, but with reality surrounding me every day, I can't sit and write about fake stuff. I write righteous words with my right hand. That's how I pray. If you disagree, trust me, God overstands, because I saw the writing on the wall and I wrote it down. I put it in my books and I peddled them around town, but I didn't sell many. In fact, I gave most of them away and I didn't make a profit off of any, but money is not my motivation. I get payment from speaking about situations that we face in this nation. Like, I've seen young black men arrested for selling crack. The brothers never come home, but the crack always comes back. Now, where them black men at? I wonder if they'll liberate my brothers now that they finish liberating Iraq. Now, some say the revolution won't be televised, but that's okay because I don't have a television set anyway. And even if I did, I wouldn't be upset because my electricity just got disconnected. And even if it was, I'd still be all right because I wouldn't be at home to watch it. I'd be in the street fighting. And if I die, I'll go on to enlightenment. And if I survive, I'll come home and start writing. Because if they passed a law that made poetry a crime, I'm breaking that law every time and I'm praying I get life.